Hey there, and welcome back to Utility Sports. Today's video, we are going to be covering the Golden State Warriors and their offseason preview. This is a very, very pivotal offseason for this team. Obviously, there needs to be some adjustments heading into next year, but obviously, Klay Thompson will be back. This is going to be a healthy Warriors team. Obviously, I mean, they were still dangerous this year. Obviously, that's not the season that they wanted to have, but They definitely made teams worry about them, especially Steph Curry. He was absolutely lights out this season, one of the best years of his career from a number standpoint and the eye test as well. So let's just step right into it here. Here are the current players under contract for the Warriors. You got Steph Curry, Klay Thompson, Andrew Wiggins, Draymond Green, and James Wiseman. Those are the key guys. And you also have some guys off the bench like Jordan Poole and Kevon Looney, Eric Pascal. There's a couple of guys that can be rotational players for them, good role players for them. Obviously, they do want to make some improvements during the offseason, but it is going to be a little tougher. Reason being, they don't have a lot of money to work with. Obviously, they can use their mid-level exception to go out and sign a role player. I think that's what obviously they're going to do. They're also maybe are going to be focusing on a potential Steph Curry extension once again. Steph Curry definitely needs to be locked down. You have to make sure that he's committed to this franchise, which I think he is. I think he's going to be a lifelong Golden State Warrior. Obviously, with Klay Thompson coming back, that changes the dynamic of this team. I think that's pretty clear and obvious that they missed him this year. Phenomenal defender, great shooter, just a really, really good team player for the Golden State Warriors. Andrew Wiggins is a guy who on the defensive end this year really stepped it up. Not a lot of people are talking about that, but he was pretty engaged on that end of the floor, and that's what a lot of people thought he could be. Definitely has the athleticism, the upside to be a two-way player, that's for sure. Phenomenal athlete and a guy that can really score. I think that's part of the issue with Andrew Wiggins is people have been underrating him just because of his contract. Yes, he has been overpaid in his career. That doesn't mean he's not a good player. He is a really, really intriguing player. A potential build around guy as well. Draymond Green obviously is the pulse of this team. You really need him to be back in a big way. And then the interesting one here is James Wiseman. Why do I say James Wiseman's the interesting guy out of this? It's because you have to make a decision if you're the Golden State Warriors. Do you want to go ahead and keep James Wiseman? Obviously you can build around him as well. But do you want to maybe trade for a veteran, a guy that better, you know, more fits this timeline? Because the championship window is right now. You have to push all of your chips forward. Do you believe James Wiseman can do that effectively? Now, that's something that we have to ask ourselves. Is this a guy that can be, you know, a key contributor right now on a championship team? I think my answer to that is yes. I think he can be a really, really great player for this team. Obviously, it's going to take a couple of years until we see the peak of James Wiseman. However, I do think it's worthy of keeping him around and obviously not, you know, pushing too hard on the gas to go get a veteran. I think that's something that they need to consider. I've seen some potential mock trades people have been putting out there with the Clippers and the Warriors potentially sending their pick 7 and a couple of other assets for Paul George. And they would also send Wiseman in that deal. Now, I don't think that's what they should really do. Obviously, if you can get Paul George, that's really, really key for this team. I think that's very well a championship team if you add a guy like him, but you're also going to have to match money. That's where it makes things a little more difficult. You're going to have to send Andrew Wiggins away, obviously, in that. So Klay, Steph, Draymond Green, Paul George, does that win a championship? I think that gives you a really good chance to win a championship. If that's your goal and aspiration, obviously they'll probably call the Clippers on that. And I don't think that the Clippers really want to do that, especially since they're trying to keep Kawhi Leonard happy. I don't know if bringing in a guy like Wiseman and Wiggins and a couple of draft picks, I mean, that's likely not going to be a championship team if we're completely honest with ourselves. So I don't think that the Clippers really want to do that. And I think the Warriors, you know, they could potentially do it, but I think they want to focus in on James Wiseman's development because he can be a special player in this league for sure. Obviously, if he can really start to stretch the floor effectively, this team's going to be very, very dangerous. A guy that can move out in space defensively, good shot blocker. So there's a lot to like about this team as a whole. But the key thing here is with those picks that they have, whether they would want to package them or do you want to just stay at said spots and really build out that bench. That's where the Warriors can be really dangerous is adding some of these guys in the draft and all of a sudden your bench is looking really, really good now. So that's kind of where the Golden State Warriors could be winning in all of this. So let's go ahead and look at their team needs. You definitely have to think about playmaking guard off the bench. I think that's a way you can get that done is through the draft, as well as a scoring and shooting wing, and also perimeter ball handlers. I think that's been a key need for them. Obviously you have Steph Curry, but you want to make sure you get a couple of more perimeter ball handlers on this team. Once again, they're going to have to do it through the draft, just considering the free agency. If they want to go ahead and use that mid-level exception to sign a veteran guard, I think that makes a lot of sense. Personally, I think that makes a ton of sense for them to do that. So those are the key needs for this team. And I think it's pretty evident after what we watched during the season, for sure. Now we're going to go ahead and take a look at free agency, little flexibility, mid-level exception on a role player. There's a couple of guys in free agency that could be interesting for them, but if they want to go ahead and get one of those underrated ball handlers, a guy that kind of comes to mind, a scoring guard in Reggie Jackson, was a guy that was brought in on the minimum for the Clippers. He was a big time playmaker in the playoffs. Was not really expected, but I feel like the Warriors can go ahead and find a guy like a Reggie Jackson, obviously not to that extent, and will likely not be the contributor that Reggie Jackson was this year, because that was just absurd how he had played. But this is a team that definitely can go out and do that using that mid-level exception. Now, looking at the draft targets, this is where it really matters for the Golden State Warriors and where they're going to go as a franchise. Obviously, some of these guys have star potential of this list. At pick 7, you could have Kuminga, you could have Barnes. I think those are the two guys that really have that true star potential. I think Davion Mitchell could be a really, really solid contributor for this team. Phenomenal perimeter defender, a really, really impactful shooter. Also, Moses Moody's another guy as well that could really slot nicely as a shooting guard for this team. But for me, if they're able to get a guy like Jonathan Kuminga, who I think can really break out and be a really nice player. Now, the nice thing for the Warriors is they have great infrastructure on the team currently. They know how to win. They know how to develop players. And for the Golden State Warriors, if they get their hands on Jonathan Kuminga, watch out. This is a talented scoring wing, can be a true three-level scorer. So that could be dangerous. And also Scotty Barnes, defensively, he's got a ton of upside. Kind of that point forward, if you will. So a little bit of playmaking there. So kind of interesting at 7. I don't know how realistic that a Scotty Barnes would be there at pick 7, but who knows? Also, obviously, Jonathan Kuminga might be a little bit of a stretch, but if that happens, if one of them falls there, I think that makes a lot of sense. And at pick 14, Corey Kispert, Jalen Johnson, Trey Murphy, Cam Thomas. I think those are all realistic options at the 14th spot. I think Corey Kispert really fits in nicely with this team, can be another impactful bench scorer, going to be a really, really effective shooter for how Golden State runs their system. Jalen Johnson, a guy that can play make a little bit, definitely a guy that is a very, very good athlete, one of the top athletes in the class as well. Trey Murphy, perfect 3-and-D guy for them, a guy that can be impactful defensively, really good length. And I think he's more than just a 3-and-D player personally. I know a lot of people have been out there saying he's just a 3-and-D guy, but I think he's got a little more in his bag than that. And then the final guy I want to talk about is Cam Thomas. Cam Thomas was really, really interesting for LSU, broke out in a big way, all-time leader in points at Oak Hill High School, goes to LSU, really, really impactful player. Their offense ran completely through him. He's a guy that can, he's a guy that's not afraid to take the tough shot. Now, that does kind of lead to some bad shots. However, he makes really, really tough shots at that shooting guard spot. He's got the 6'4 frame. He could be a true bench scorer for this team. If you need Cam Thomas to lead that second unit for the Warriors, he's going to do it. He's going to do it with volume. You're going to have some really good games. You're going to have some really bad games from him. But the key thing is you get that guy that can handle the rock a little bit and put the ball in the hoop on that second unit. I think that's where he's really, really valuable for this team. So overall, they have a lot of really good options. To kind of sum it up, you have to decide, are you going to build around James Wiseman or are you not going to and trade him for a veteran? That's something that we have to figure out. And in that deal, if you do move Wiseman, it's likely that Wiggins has to go. So I want you to let me know in the comment section below, keep or trade Wiseman. That's going to be a big discussion in the NBA world as free agency and the draft goes on. Also, let me know in the comment section below, If you are a Warriors fan, who do you want at 7 and 14? Really critical picks for this franchise. Thanks for tuning in. Subscribe if you are new to the channel. Also, leave a like if you did enjoy the video. Thanks for tuning in, and we will see you in the very, very next video.